recently there's been some concern that those on a 100% plant-based diet are deficient in vitamin A. This is because preformed vitamin A is found only in animal products. However, our body can create it out of carotenoids, like beta-carotene. Now, there is some truth to these concerns, because in 2001, the Food and Nutrition Board doubled the amount of beta-carotene they said was enough to meet vitamin A needs. They said this change was based on, quote, data demonstrating that the vitamin A activity of dietary beta-carotene is 1/6 rather than 1/3 the vitamin activity of purified beta-carotene in oil. This change in bioconversion means that a larger amount of provitamin A carotenoids, and therefore darkly coloured carotene-rich fruits and vegetables, is needed to meet the vitamin A requirement. It also means that in the past, vitamin A intake has been overestimated. We need to take this very seriously, as vitamin A deficiency can cause night blindness, and if it progresses, can lead to the more severe eye problems of corneal ulcers, scarring, and blindness. So we know that preformed vitamin A exists only in animal products. But did you know that there are about 50 carotenoids that the body can convert into vitamin A, with the most common being beta-carotene? As some of these carotenoids can be converted into vitamin A, attempts have been made to determine how much of them in the diet is equivalent to a particular amount of retinol, so that comparisons can be made of the benefit of different foods. In 2001, the US Institute of Medicine came up with a unit called the retinol activity equivalent. So here is the vitamin A content of plant foods measured in retinol activity equivalents. As you can see, other than carrot juice, sweet potato is the second highest source of beta-carotene. Here are the dietary reference intakes for vitamin A. But what if there was a food we could add, say, to our sweet potato that could increase beta-carotene absorption and conversion? Well, there is. Research has shown that avocados increase beta-carotene absorption and conversion to vitamin A. This study looked at whether eating avocado could increase vitamin A levels in the blood after meals, and researchers found that adding half of an avocado to a high carotenoid meal increased the amount of carotenoids absorbed. And not only that, it also increased the amount of vitamin A in the blood by about 3 to 6 times compared to a high carotenoid meal without avocado. I must just add a small disclaimer that research suggests that those suffering from cardiovascular disease should not eat avocado. For more information, please see this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe for more upcoming videos.